So if you're just getting started with your research and you feel a little bit stressed out about how should you go about actually learning your field and creating ideas, I want to give you a playbook today to be able to go and do that. Before I get started, I do want to let you know that I have a 30-day research jumpstart guide that's meant to help walk you through these steps even further, and it gives you a week-by-week instructions of what to do to be able to learn your field, generate ideas, and start collecting data within 30 days. You can download that in the link in the description below. Today, I'm going to talk about three main things that you should think about whenever you're going to learn your field. A lot of us, when we start learning our field, go to other people and say, hey, can you give me books to read or papers to read? Or we go on Google Scholar and search some massive field. In like my case, I study mass spectrometry, so I might put mass spectrometry into Google Scholar, and then it gives me a ton of information that's really all not that useful, depending on what the specific field I'm studying is. So the first thing that I want you to do is think about the main 2 to 4 keywords that actually describes the field that you're planning on studying. So in my case, when I was getting started, I knew that I was going to be studying something related to metabolites, ion mobility, and mass spectrometry. So those are my 3 keywords to start putting into search engines to find relevant papers to what I need to know. So once you've created your 2 to 4 keywords, you can go to something like Google Scholar. And if you don't know how to work Google Scholar just yet, check out the video above that walks through my entire tutorial on how to use Google Scholar and its search logic. But you want to go to Google Scholar and you're going to plug in combinations of those keywords and kind of figure out what are the papers that come out yet. You can start downloading these papers, but before you set out on like a 30-day hiatus to read all of these papers, just wait just a second. Because the first thing I want you to look at is review papers. So you want to look at literature reviews that really touches on each of your topics that you're interested in. If you start combining these topics, there may not be literature reviews in that area, but if there are in the combined topics, start with those first. This will give you a good foundation for what you need to know to be able to understand the research being performed in the field. Once you have a good number of literature reviews under your belt, generally 2 to 3 read all the way through is usually a good start. The next thing I would do is look for research papers using those keywords that are past the date of your published review. So these are going to be your more recent research so that you get a good understanding of what's been done since that review. Then you can look through several of these papers, get an idea of where the field is going, and then start generating topic ideas based on these. Once you've read through all these different papers, the third thing that you want to do is, if you can, start looking for research presentations to go to. So if you have conferences or seminars that put their presentations up online, then go to those. Or if you have like small subgroups or things like that, go to those and watch what other people are doing. If you don't have access to any of these, go and start talking to your own colleagues about what they're doing in their research when it's similar to yours. So talking to your lab mates and your advisors is really good in this to really get the most up-to-date research, because your older lab mates have probably gone to those conferences and know a little bit about what people in this area are doing. The main mistake that I see grad students making is holding off starting their research until they've read a massive list of papers. So you might have a folder on your desktop that's populated with all these different papers that you think you need to read before you maybe go get in the lab or start doing research. And this is actually going to put you behind, because by actually going out and doing the research, it's going to make those other papers seem a lot more clear because you understand what's going on. I wouldn't read more than a couple reviews and maybe 2 to 3 research papers before you start actually starting your research. The main question you want to go in with whenever you're reading those research papers is either, what is my research idea is a good first question if you don't have that down yet. And then if you do know your research idea, you want to jump into what are the methods I need to do to study this research idea. So those are the questions you should jump in while you're reading your research papers to be able to more easily get ready to actually perform that research. This way you're not wasting all of your time reading papers that really isn't pushing your field forward, even though it may make you feel productive, which is a lot of the times what we do is we do things that make us feel productive and read a bunch of papers, and it also allows us to not have to face the fear of actually doing our research and moving our research forward. So just to go ahead and recap, if you're first learning your field, the first thing I want you to do is develop the keywords around your field to be able to search them in some form of scholarly search engine. Next thing is look specifically for reviews related to those keywords to give you a good background for your field. The third thing is then look for research papers that have been published since those reviews to let you know kind of the research that's actually going on currently. Then go look at research presentations and talk to your peers and colleagues to get a really good understanding of your current field. Then once you've done that, that should take you maybe a month, if that, to go ahead and get started, depending on how much time you have to dedicate to your research. And then jump into your research and start collecting data. You're going to make mistakes when you first start doing research. It's okay. Not every experiment is going to turn out well, but those mistakes are going to give you the experiences you need to actually move your research forward instead of feeling stuck reading paper after paper, because that can instill a lot of fear in you sometimes. If you're still with me, make sure you download the 30-day research jumpstart guide I have below. It walks you through these steps in a lot more details with a lot more actionable steps within them so that you can feel really confident in learning your field and actually start collecting data. I hope this was helpful, and I look forward to seeing you in the next video.